If you've ever grown tomatoes, you may have had the extremely frustrating experience of flower drop.
I am a tomato plant. I am going to annoy my gardener.
Let's check on the tomato plants. Because the blooms on tomato plants are what eventually turns into the fruit themselves, having a loss of flowers is ultimately going to lead to a decreased harvest. So what can you do about this? Hi, my name's Lucas, and in this video, I'm gonna be discussing the reasons for tomato plant flower drop, and also what you can do to prevent this from happening. So many mosquitoes in here. So the first cause of tomato plants not setting fruit is extreme temperatures. If you're growing tomatoes in a very hot climate, like say Southern California, what can happen is the pollen in the flowers can actually kind of clump up, and then the flowers can't get pollinated. The same sort of thing can happen in extremely cold temperatures. So you're asking me, Lucas, okay, what can I do to solve this? The biggest thing you can do is to pick varieties that are well suited to your climate. So if you live in a super hot climate, you want to pick varieties that are known to set fruit well in the heat. Conversely, if you live in a very cold climate, you want to pick varieties that will set fruit well in a cooler environment. Now, of course, variety isn't everything. Timing is also very important. When you plant your seeds, when you plant your plants in the ground is also going to determine how many of the flowers that your tomato plant sets is actually going to produce nice fruits for you. So by now you're probably thinking, okay, great. I know what to do in the future, but what do I do right now? That's a great question, and I'm going to try to answer it as best as I can. So basically, tomato plants not setting fruit is an issue of pollination. So what can you do to increase pollination of your plants? There's a lot of articles on the internet and a lot of videos on YouTube that recommend hand pollinating your tomato flowers. Most of them recommend doing this with an electric toothbrush. What you do with this method is you go up to your tomato plant with an electric toothbrush, switch it on, and put it on your tomato flower. In theory, this will vibrate the tomato flowers, dislodge the pollen, and pollinate them. Some variations on this method include smacking your tomato plants or whacking them with a roll of newspaper. Do I use this method, and do I recommend you use this method? Absolutely not, for some reasons which I'll discuss now. In my opinion, this is a waste of time because tomato flowers are usually self-pollinating. If your tomato plants aren't setting fruit, it's likely due to environmental conditions causing the pollen to clump up. If you've got a few tomato plants, go ahead. But if you've got a large garden, this method is extremely inefficient. A much better use of your time would be planting flowers that would attract beneficial pollinating insects such as bees. In my garden this year, I'm growing zinnias to do just that. I also have these two spiry bushes that attract plenty of bumblebees. So lack of pollination shouldn't be an issue in my garden. And if you plant some flowers, it shouldn't be in yours either. Another reason your tomato plants might not be setting fruit is that they're just not healthy enough. They're not getting the correct nutrients they need to grow and thrive. In order to combat this, make sure to add lots of compost to your soil every year. And also, use fertilizers that will increase the nutrients and minerals available to your tomato plants. The key is to give your tomato plants lots of phosphorus, the macronutrient responsible for root, flower, and fruit development. So if you're going to use a fertilizer, look at the NPK ratio. Make sure the middle number is the highest. This will help to ensure that your tomato plants are setting the maximum number of fruits. Along with keeping your tomato plants healthy, it's important to have a regular watering schedule. Also, make sure your plants are located in an area that gets a full 8 to 10 hours of sun each day. All right, growers, that's it for today's video. Hope you learned how to boost the fruit set on your tomato plants to get that big, juicy harvest at the end of the season. My name's Lucas, and I'm out. We'll be right back.